So, my name is Klaus, or also known as Sualco on GitHub. I will give you the latest update on the JavaScript XMPP client. It's also known as the chat app for Nextcloud. As you can see on the screenshot, we have a bunch of features. So the most important one is that we use the popular chat protocol XMPP. XMPP is federated and completely open, so everyone can contribute to it. Beside this, we also have end-to-end encrypted two-party communication, so we use here off-the-record messaging. We have group chats, file transfer. The chat app is translated into 9 different languages. We have notifications and a lot more. But who develops this client? So it's mainly those 4 guys. It's me, of course, Marcel, Daniel, and Tobias. And most important, a growing community, because without beta testers, bug reporters, and with the feedback from the community, this would not be possible. And also the translators, of course, it's very important. How does this app work? So, it's a client, so this means we need a server, an XMPP server, and there's also a second requirement. If you install the app in your Nextcloud, we need a common authentication backend, because to unify the login, you have to use the same credential on both systems. Because this is not easy to set up, for example, if you use an LDAP, we created an authentication module. So now you are able to use the same credentials in your Nextcloud installation and your XMPP server. And not only your XMPP server can now use your Nextcloud user base, but also every service who supports SASL OAuth. So for example, you can use your Nextcloud password to authenticate on your Cyrus server. I think that's pretty cool. And also this module has support for time-limited tokens. This means the server can generate some kind of password for you. So this also works for Nextcloud installation, which use, for example, Shibboleth. But not everyone is able to install or willing to install their own XMPP server, for example, because they have some web hosting, and therefore we created an internal backend. So this is a small XMPP server written in PHP. It's the default configuration, so it runs on every installation, but it has some limitations compared to the external server. For example, you are not able to connect with every client to this server, so you can only use it in Nextcloud. You cannot use it on your PC or smartphone, and you cannot use the federated feature of XMPP, so you can only chat with members of your Nextcloud. Now we have a simple to use backend and a little bit more complicated installation with the external server, and now we thought it would be interesting to have something in between. That's why we founded the Federated Communication Association, which provides you an XMPP server hosting for free for small Nextcloud installations. So as you can see here, it's a beta service. This means we have limited the number of registration, but if you have a working registration, then you have your own XMPP server. So you have your own domain, and you can use it with every phone or with every XMPP client. So I think that's pretty cool, and it's super easy to set up. So just install the latest version of the JavaScript XMPP client, go to the admin settings, select the managed server type, and click register. And you're done. I think that's pretty cool. To conclude, we think the chat app and Nextcloud fits perfect together, and we'd love to work with you guys, and we're looking forward to see what comes next. If you want to get more information on this, just talk to me or visit our homepage, jsxc.org. Thank you.